Hey everybody, Clay Archer, CEO of DPC Technology, and I've got a really awesome one today. Today, I'm going to be showing you the new Unifi Device Bridge. How many times have you thought to yourself, man, I really wish I could have a PoE camera on this side of my house or this side of my building? Or how about a PoE phone or any device, really, where you have a power outlet, but you don't have a Cat 6 jack to plug the device into? Well, Ubiquiti's got your back, and they solved the problem with this cool little device. So basically, this is really just a PoE injector adapter with Wi-Fi built into it. So basically, you're going to plug this thing into the wall, you're going to plug it into the PoE device, and your WAPs and your Unifi network device are going to automatically find this and prompt you to install it. Super, super easy. And it's going to give you a 1 gigabit LAN port with 15 watts of PoE power. It's going to work on the 5 gigahertz band with up to 867 megabits per second throughput rate, which is awesome. It's got a software switchable antenna and is compatible with Unifi Protect PoE cams, talk phones, and various Internet of Things devices, and provides internet connection. So this is a really cool device. Obviously, it's not PoE++, so you're not going to push a G4 PTZ industrial. So the only limitation here is that it's 1 gigabit, which is going to be fine for 99.99% of IoT things, and that it is only 15 watts of PoE power. So, you know, check your devices to make sure that they are going to be able to be powered by this device. Typical Unifi packaging is awesome. Obviously, I'll roll some B-roll there so you can see what all is included in the box. And with that, let's jump into the software. I'm gonna go ahead and get this adopted on my phone real quick and show you what that process looks like. Real quickly, I will show you that when I log into my cloud key and go to network, my UDB does show up here and it does prompt me to connect to the device. But I'm gonna follow the instructions which told me to log into it on my phone. So we'll go over to my phone real quick and you can see I've already logged in and it's already prompted me that it's found a new device. I'm gonna go ahead and click adopt on that. And it says unknown device. I'm going to go ahead and adopt it. And it will roll through the adoption process. It's saying it's a UDB up at the top there. You can see on my desktop now it's given its correct icon as it's adopting. So that's really wicked. You can see as it was adopting there, it showed that it found the G5 turret attached to it. I'm going to let that roll through because it's still loading on my phone, but that was pretty awesome. In real time, it automatically found that G5 turret that I've got connected to it. Awesome. So that took maybe a couple minutes. Looks like it's good. And I can see on my phone all the information about it. I'm gonna stop using my phone now. I'm going to jump over to network on my desktop and we'll finish the installation. All right. So I'm not going to adopt the camera in here because I use the camera in my UNVR Pro. So I'm not going to adopt it here. But let's go through what we've got here on this port manager, which is really cool. It's a port manager just like you would see on one of your switches. You can see that it's connected. You can see it's connected at 100 megabits, which is what the G5 turret connects at. And you've got a basic reading of how good your connection is. So it's a pretty good connection. I'm pulling it off of an ACHD, and I can go into my port manager here, and I could obviously change things on the ports, rename ports, that kind of stuff. So I can come in here and I could change its VLAN if I wanted to, get insights on it as well. Pretty cool stuff, you know, if you're going to come through here and try and diagnose an issue or whatever. It's good to have all this, you know, this data. You can see it tells me what it's connected to, FE speed on the port, and the name of it. I could also go back to the device again. You can also come in here and change, you know, change the name of it, change the antenna type, IP settings, you know, static or DHCP. You can copy configuration from one to another. That's pretty cool. And obviously locate, restart, remove, pretty normal functions. Yeah, under insights, you get some basic statistics. I think you'd probably be better served to go into port manager and kind of look at it through there. Also in the basic overview page, you're going to get all your information and statistics. And that might be helpful for you when you're trying to figure out your port speed issues, if you're having any port speed issues. So really quickly, I'm going to go ahead and jump over into my UNVR Pro and go ahead and adopt that camera and see what that process is like. All right, so I'm back over in our UNVR Pro, and it automatically found the G5 Turret Ultra, which is awesome. So I'm just going to click Add there, and now I'm going to go ahead and click it. You can see I've got some other cameras that I'm testing on this kind of stuff. Let's go ahead and adopt this G5 Turret Ultra. And you can see now it is adopting, and it has been added. Let's see what we get here. Bearing update. I'm sure it's going to have to go through a couple of different firmware updates on it. All right, so you can see the G5 Turret Ultra is updating. It's going to take a couple more minutes. I have to say, you know, I've reviewed a ton of Unifi products over the years and done a ton of kind of these early testing on things. I have to say this is one of the smoothest and easiest installs of any product I've ever tested by them. I was a little concerned, you know, hey, you know, I'm going from a WAP to a PoE. I got a lot of things here. I'm also running it on the UNVR, although the network is running on the cloud key. This has all gone so smoothly. I'm probably just jinxed myself because I don't have it completely installed yet. But as it's coming on now, this installation has been flawless and super easy. And two big thumbs up on this product so far. But let's finish this up. Let's test it a little bit. Let's see what the image quality looks like. And we'll kind of go from there. You can see it's a G5 Turret Ultra. We've got 30 frames per second, 10 megabit per second bit rate. And uptime has been 2 minutes here. Looking like a really good image. Daniel's over there in his cubicle. You can see this is just a really, really nice image. I got it on HQ here. I don't have any shuttering. It's looking really good. I've got sound. That was a super easy install. I don't know whether that came through over on YouTube, but I am really stoked about how easy that setup was and how well the device is performing. All right, the Unifi Device Bridge. What a cool little device. I have a feeling they're going to sell the heck out of it. I don't have the final release price. It'll either be on an overlay on the screen right now or down in the description below. But this is going to be another one of those Unifi devices that is going to be very hard for them to keep in stock. This is going to be a real game changer. I was debating on doing a little bit deeper dive into it. But honestly, I think for the use case that most people are going to use it for phones, for Protect cameras, for IoT devices, this is going to just work for you. It's a really nice device. Obviously, testing wireless is tough. And you can see most of the reviewers don't do a ton of wireless reviews because there are so many environmental factors that come into play. But I can tell you in my office, this is a 10,000 square foot building. I've been playing with it a little bit and I've been able to get from corner to corner of my office, really good reception and everything's working. So on throughput, it has been more than enough to run a G5 Ultra Turret, which is basically probably what I'll run through it. Also more than enough to run Unifi Talk or any other phone system that you're running. This is going to be a really super popular device. It's going to save a lot of time and money running Cat 6 cables here and there and everywhere. But also the PoE aspect of it is really awesome. So this is probably one of my favorite devices from Unifi that I have reviewed in quite some time. I have a feeling that if you want one, you should go out and buy it right now. And please leave any comments or questions down below. I do read every one of those and respond to them. Also, if you have anything else you want us to test, put it down below. As always, please like and subscribe, and we'll see you guys in the next video.